The importance of our words cannot be overstated. The stories that we're constantly telling ourselves and telling other people, backed with emotions, that creates our reality. Hello, my loves, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, I'm Leora Alexandra. Welcome to the Baby Elephant community. In this channel, we talk about the law of attraction, spirituality, self-development, and so much more. This is the first video that I am recording after my two-week battle with Bell's palsy. I'm looking at myself in the rear view and I'm so grateful. I'm definitely not 100% back to full mobility at the left side of my face, but I can smile, I can close my eye, I can do a lot of things that I wasn't able to do. And I actually have a vlog that I will post about it, but I didn't want to share a video about everything that I went through ahead of time because the blog can be a little bit sad sometimes because it's like, you know, I was going through something a little difficult. So I wanted to share this. I feel like I am 100 times better than I was 2 weeks ago. And let me tell you the story. So Bell's palsy is basically the 7th facial nerve getting inflamed and compressed. So it goes from here and it kind of leads out over here like little like roots. It's actually a really cool imagery. And this nerve, when it gets inflamed and compressed, basically what happens is you lose the ability to move the left side of your face. And there is a lot of complications that come with that. My hearing was kind of going, I couldn't really see from my left eye. I couldn't taste from the left side of my mouth. I could only taste from the right side. I could barely chew on the left side anyways. I had to keep using my finger to move food around because it just, you don't have full control over your muscles, over your face. And it was pretty difficult. It is pretty difficult. I couldn't really speak. I would blow my P's and B's. So I'd be like, probably, things like that. It was really difficult. This is the second time that I've gotten Bell's palsy. So the first time that I got it, I was 13 years old. It was exactly 13 years ago. And at that time, we went to emergency right away. I woke up with it and we went to the emergency room and we were told, this is Bell's palsy. We don't know why you have it, but what we do is we prescribe steroids for the first week and that should help you. And I'm sorry if I'm not really blinking all the way, but it's part of the healing process. Steroids should help you, it should help the healing process, and eventually you'll regain mobility of your face. So I took steroids when I was 13 and it took me 6 months to regain mobility in the left side of my face. 6 months in middle school with kids picking on me, being mean about it. It was really hard. It was a pretty difficult time, but thank God it was just that. And I also believe that it was affecting my brain a little bit. It affected my brain a little bit this past time as well. So it's not just a physical, visual thing. It's also how you feel internally. You just don't feel right. You feel uncomfortable. It's painful. It's not fun. Anyways, I decided this time around to not go to the doctor, not take allopathic medicine, not take steroids, and heal myself holistically. Now, before I get into what I did and the whole process of everything that I did, I do want to say I'm not a medical expert in any way at all. All I'm sharing right now is my own personal recovery story in comparison to when I did use allopathic medicine when I was 13 years old. My thoughts on healing is that everything starts at an energetic level, and things start with our stories, the things that we tell ourselves. The way that we feel gets trapped in our body if it's not released. Emotions get trapped. And when you feel certain emotions, that ends up leading to physical disability, pain, disease, chronic pain, whatever it is, weight gain. And with that emotional release and without properly kind of deep diving into your subconscious and conscious minds and seeing who you are as a person and where you need to improve, what you need to work on, when we just live in autopilot, that's when we get sick. That's why there's so many people in this world today who are so sick, chronic pain, chronic weight gain, like just not doing well. And it really does starts on an emotional and energetic level. And I took this belief of mine and I was faced as my face started to freeze. It takes about 48 hours for the full expression of the Bell's palsy to occur. I made this decision within myself. Am I going to go get steroids, go to an allopathic doctor, to Western medicine, whatever, and basically not follow anything that I preach or believe in? Or am I going to take this as a challenge and as a reminder to myself of how powerful I am, how powerful healing is, how powerful our bodies are, and how powerful the words we speak and the way that we think, what that could do to our physical bodies and to our healing and to our health? So I chose the latter. I chose to do this my own way. And I created a regimen for myself, morning and night, and you know, 2 weeks later, my face started to move and my hearing returned, my eyesight returned, my taste buds returned, and I healed myself. And honestly, I'm sure people will be looking for it in this video, but if you see me in person, you really can't tell anything is wrong. And if anything, I truly believe that when I was 13 and took those steroids, that my nerve and that my muscles healed incorrectly, because there was always something a little bit off about my face. Through law of attraction, through spirituality, I was able to create a lot more cohesion in my face. And many people might be able to notice that if they see older videos of mine and newer videos of mine, my face looked, the past year or so much more balanced, so much more cohesive. And I feel like when Bell's palsy arose this time around again, it gave me the opportunity to fully heal the nerve. I feel like my muscles and my face have healed more cohesively and more balanced than they were before I got Bell's palsy again. So I believe that this re-emergence of this disorder was giving me the opportunity to heal myself right this time, which would go hand in hand with this entire theme of my year. All I've been focusing on is healing, 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 purging all my shadows, bringing them to the light and bringing more light into my vessel. And it would make sense to me that if I didn't heal through what I was going through correctly the first time around, that this time I was given the chance to truly heal myself. Now, I want to talk about the words aspect of it and the stories. For the past few months, I've been feeling very stuck. And I would talk about this to my friends and to my family, to Aaron and to everybody a lot. I would just say, I feel stuck. I was in a situation where I felt really stuck. And creatively, I just kept feeling stagnation. And I realize now, obviously, it would be so silly that I didn't realize it before, of course, because this is what I teach, this is what I talk about all the time. But I realize now that I kept repeating the same story. I feel stuck, I feel stuck, I feel stuck. And that story was backed up by my emotions. I was really stagnant energy. And what did my body do? At first, for the first part of those first few months, I was sleeping like this, super tense. But I was ignoring it. I didn't go see what's happening. I didn't talk about it to my acupuncturist. I was ignoring it. Till one day I woke up and my face actually was stuck. My body was showing me, look at this. You have to acknowledge this and you have to deal with this now. There's no other time but now. Look at what you've done to yourself. You feel stuck? Look, you're really stuck now. And my face got freaking stuck. And my friends and my family will tell you, they remember me talking about this, saying this, that this is how I felt over and over and over again. And that was the first part of the healing, becoming aware and taking responsibility that I had done this to myself. Though I'm aware of what our stories do for us and what the things we keep repeating can create, I still did it. I still talked about being stuck. So what I did to heal my Bell's palsy, I did a lot of different things. First and foremost, I did acupuncture twice a week. That is a timing thing. If you develop some sort of tense or inflammation, I highly recommend going to see an acupuncturist ASAP. Twice a week was perfect for me. Within the first week, I saw a tiny bit of movement, a tiny bit of improvement. By the fourth session, I had already been like 85% healed. Now, this went hand in hand with my emotional release. I had a conversation that was very difficult for me to have, but I had to get it out because that was the reason why I was feeling stuck, because I was swallowing my truth. I was swallowing how I felt. I wasn't expressing myself, and that showed up in my physical body. My body was holding on to a lot of weight prior to this, and I think that my body was just kind of trying to show my higher self, and my body was trying to show me through different ways, like, observe this, pay attention to this, pay attention. And I wasn't paying attention. So then it was literally right in my face, right in my face. So I talked my way into being stuck, and then I decided to talk my way out of it. I had that conversation because at that point, I came to full recognition that I can't hold this in anymore. Look at what I'm doing to myself. I had the conversation and I felt better immediately after. However, of course, there's this thing called momentum. And when you spend months talking a certain way, one conversation is not going to reverse everything. I needed to build up momentum the other way. So after that conversation was over and it went really well, so much better than I had expected it to go, and it was just something that I really needed to happen. You know, we play these things over in our mind and we think it's going to be something so scary to do, but just do whatever is scaring you. You might have to have a conversation with yourself that you haven't been wanting, or somebody else, or you might have to make some sort of change that you're afraid will affect somebody else, but you got to do it. You can't hold this stuff in because you could really, really hurt yourself. So acupuncture and emotional release, I also did breath work, releasing a lot of things that were in my body that I was holding on to so tightly that my ego wanted to hold on to. Breath work helped me to release that. I also used CBD, a lot of CBD, because there were a lot of studies that showed that inflammation and Bell's palsy can be cured through CBD. So I got a full spectrum CBD, which I will show you guys all in the vlog. The full spectrum aspect of it allows for more cannabinoids, which together have a synergetic effect that really is super, super healing. So acupuncture, emotional release, breath work, CBD, turmeric capsules. I got the most bioavailable turmeric capsules I could find. Turmeric, whatever, curcumin. This is absolutely amazing for inflammation. If you suffer from inflammation, adding this to your diet, making sure that's a very bioavailable one, will really help you. I also started taking vegan B12, which I had stopped taking for a while. I just forgot about it. That helped a lot. I spent a lot of time in sunlight. I spent a lot of time sleeping, relaxing, and meditating. The meditation aspect of it, I would say, is the most important one, and I'm actually going to create a meditation for you based on that meditation that I was doing for myself. What I was doing in this meditation is taking myself to a sort of hall of records, flipping through different timelines and choosing the timeline where I was my healthiest, happiest self, picking it up and then covering myself with it, effectively stepping into that reality and choosing that optimal timeline. I will create a guided meditation for you guys for this because it's super powerful. When I wasn't doing that, I was also doing my Chamber of Light meditation, which is already available. It's really my most underrated meditation ever. I highly recommend doing it if you have any sort of emotional or physical healing that needs to happen. If you need more energy, if you need some self-care, do this meditation, preferably before bed or when you wake up in the morning. Lastly, I just accepted my situation. I realized that I don't know what's going to happen. It took me 6 months to heal from Bell's palsy last time. I had no idea that within 2 weeks I'd be able to be on camera again. I had no idea. So I had to really accept where I was at. And I decided that regardless of whether my face would be paralyzed or not, I will continue to make videos, I will continue to pursue my dreams, and nothing would stop me. It might be a little bit more difficult, it might be more difficult to express myself and to be myself, but I was going to do it regardless. And that acceptance of self, no matter what, I think was huge for the healing process. Now, I did so many other things to heal myself, and I could really expand on all the things that I mentioned here today. I'd like to know if you guys want me to do more videos about this. I could talk about it for a lot longer, but I'm trying to keep my videos a little shorter because people have been complaining. So I will post vlogs and I will also answer your questions. Leave a question in this video below so I can continue to make these videos on healing. Also, let me know if you want that guided meditation that I spoke about, that I did for myself, and I will make it for you happily. It's so powerful. It's kind of based on the Dr. Joe Dispenza meditations, but I never actually got any of his meditations. I just read his books, so I created this meditation from my knowledge from those books. So let me know if you want that, and thank you for listening. It feels so freaking amazing to be back on camera. Future is looking promising, and thanks for waiting for me to get better. Thank you for everybody on Twitter and Instagram, were so amazing. I got so much love and support. I'm so lucky to have you guys. And just so you know, you're on my gratitude list every single morning. You really are. I love you. And yeah, let's talk. Leave a comment below. thumbs up this video if you want more videos on healing. And until next time, as always, keep your vibrations way, way, way up.